Fuck you, bitch, I'm up here. What's going on, everybody? Cardock here. Today we are going to be doing some Fallout 4. Yes, I know. Game's been out for like a fucking year and a half. Everybody's played it. Everybody's finished it. Everybody knows how... Look, I fucking love this game, okay? I was dying for more when I got done playing in Vegas. And lo and behold, like a year later, Bethesda comes out at E3 and is like, yeah, so we completely revamped everything. I lost my shit. I have put, I don't even know how many freaking hours. Matter of fact, let's check real quick, shall we? Okay, so to give you an idea of just how much I've played this game since it came out, 24 days and 19 hours. So let's do the math real quick here. 24 times 24, 576. Plus 19, it's 595 hours of gameplay I put into this game. Yeah, I freaking love this game. So, I am personally more than happy to keep on playing. But, let me shut the hell up and we'll get back to the actual game. Anyway, basically what I'm going to be doing this level, you will get to see some gameplay. I'm probably going to grind through this because I wanted to play today. I haven't played this one in a while. I've been too busy getting other videos out and trying to fine-tune shit with some of the other games. But, yeah, I just figured I'd share with y'all some gameplay. I will give y'all a quick tour. I don't know if anyone else is as much a pack rat in these kind of games as I am. But I have started to build, like, basically a museum of all the stuff that I've done in the game. So, I'll let y'all take a look at that. And completely by coincidence, by the way, I did notice which shirt I'm wearing today. Bit of trivia for everyone. If you don't know what the little guy sitting there with his thumb up like that means, they were taught during the Cold War that if you hold your thumb up over a nuclear explosion and you can still see the top part of the blast, you are inside of the Fallout zone and you need to get out. So it's not just Fallout Boy being, Vault Boy being all happy and like, yeah, good job. It's literally, am I going to die or not from nuclear radiation? But then again, anyone who's ever played Fallout a day in their life should know this game is big on the grim humor. Oh god, especially New Vegas, that one was really bad. But yeah, I can't even begin to describe how much of a diehard fan that I am of this entire title. I'm really looking forward to seeing what the next Fallout has to offer. I don't know what it'll be. I know what I would like to see, but that's another video for another time. This go around, we're just going to be cruising around, checking out the fun stuff, and I'm going to be showing off a little bit. I'll try to keep... Actually, no, I'm not, because there's no point in me even going to the place that I'm going to if I do try to avoid the spoilers. So there you go. That is your official spoiler alert. From here on out, it's all spoilers. But anyway, off we go. I chose to use the island simply because once you get that system on, there's no attacks. Occasionally I think super mutants could show up there and occasionally you'll have Mire Lords try to come, but I don't have any settlers living there. The initial spawn is just a small workshop, place to repair my armor. Right now I am cruising in Brotherhood of Steel. You can see it, there we go. My Brotherhood of Steel armor, I do need to fix it up, but I ain't worried about it right now. I'm not doing anything combat related. But yeah, you know, just the basic stuff. I do have a set of Mark III XO1 armor. Got all these little knickknacks here. That was the original armor you find at the very beginning of the game. Some flags and shit. I'll show y'all what's up there in just a second. But yeah, I went ahead and picked up one of the badass totems from the Raider groups from Nuka-Cola World. And up here we have all the flags of the various factions flying. It's Institute. Institute's not up there yet. That's right. Okay, so in this playthrough, I have not yet visited the Institute. I was busy knocking out all the DLC content first. But I did make some minor modifications. As you can tell, I have already completed Vault 88. I made some modifications to this place mostly because it looked better and I wanted to be able to be sure the power could spread properly. Don't mind this mess. This is all going to get fixed up before I finish this playthrough. I might keep you all along for that if y'all decide that you like it. But yeah, so there's another one of my armors. Let's see, Skinny Malone's outfit. Much skinnier on the armor rack. My original vault suit, my original armor before I actually got into this power armor. Obviously the Mechanist. Some of the weapons I've picked up over time. The Buzz Blade, a Bloodied Sledgehammer, you know, just random cool shit. I don't even have to explain that one to you. Modified that one. And that's the one that you pick up inside the little mart. But yeah, I got the junk jet. I've already got one of the harpoon guns. I'm still got to get the Fat Man of Choice and the Laser Gatling gun of choice. But let's move on. So this will be the Vault Tech, I guess, display area. I haven't gotten Vault 99 or Vault 95 yet, and I think that's the only vaults in the game. I'm having trouble remembering right now. It's been a minute since I played. But yeah, I got my Vault teched out armor. It's all the T-51, which, quite frankly, has my favorite. This is the best looking helmet of all of them. Fuck the X-01's helmet. I think those eyes look stupid unless they're lit up red. In here, we have Brotherhood of Steel. Not completed yet. I still got to collect all the different armors. You know, just did the little neon thing and everything like that. Over here will be various weapons. I think, yeah, I did. I did put a sword in here just because it seems like the nice kind of, it fits with the whole theme. Yeah, powering the whole settlement's this giant fucking reactor because, yeah, giant fucking reactors, right? So anyway, this is from, I haven't put the sign back up yet. So this is from Far Harbor. We got the Vim stuff. These two right here came with the DLC. Most people don't realize is those are the two movies that were playing inside of the at the movie theater, the drive-in movie theater in Far Harbor. So that's why those went up. A few different weapons. I got the revolver. I actually did pick it up in Far Harbor. It's a Nuka-Cola add-on, but I picked it up in Far Harbor. I have no idea why it was there. Fence Buster from Vault 88. Vault 118. Bloodletter, which is what you get finished in the Cassidy quest. Fish Catcher, which I think you get. I think you get it for the cap. No, you get the captain's hat for the captain's hat. I don't remember what you do to get the Fish Catcher. The Striker from the bowling alley, and yes, it does fire bowling balls. It's amazing. Bit of a sad side story if you ever stop by the 10 Pin Alley or whatever it was in inside of Far Harbor. But it's a really sad side story if you go ahead and finish it up. Admiral's Friend, I believe you buy from Allen up there. You got the little Vim machine. I got the Vim sodas. Both of the power armors. I believe there's a third power armor, but I haven't found it. It's still kind of, nobody really knows for the decoration. This is that the diving suit you get for completing Avery's quest to help Far Harbor. That's Acadia's shield. That's the captain's hat. Now, funny thing about Acadia's shield, Acadia no longer exists. So I found a way to complete the quests in such a manner that allows you to get all the goodies from all the factions, and you still get to decide. You still get to blow up people if you want to. Yeah, there's the Marine combat armor, the wetsuit. We have Tectus's get up over here. His personal gamma gun in there also. That's the rags that you get when you first show up, Inquisitor's cowl, and this beautiful little thing right here. It's a pretty gnarly weapon. I did pick up, if I can find it, there it is. I did get the kiloton radiant rifle. You know, it adds 15 damage when you fire it, 15 explosive damage when you fire it. It's really effective against Myrolords. But, so, and here is my Nuka-Cola world. This is still under construction. I'm not finished yet. That's why there's a big gaping fucking hole in the wall. But, over here, this is going to be partially the pack and partially the little area where the what'd you call it? Yeah, I don't remember what exactly it was called. I'm sorry, y'all. Like I said, it has been a long time since I played this. I'm talking like 3 or 4 weeks just because I have been so busy trying to get stuff with the VA situated, stuff with YouTube situated, stuff with my car, stuff with my family. Like, it has been one thing after a freaking another. But it's all good. Everything has actually worked out to much of my benefits. It's just now that I'm actually really going to be able to start putting out the kind of content I wanted to. Enough of my sob story, though. Yes, Cito Sinus Slugger. You get that from beating the or helping out Cito, Cito friend. This is the western area here, and the kind of, well, that guy's western, but these two. And it's just random shit that I picked up around the thing. Got a token dispenser, which you can actually use if you have pre-war money. I keep pre-war money. It's easier to sell it and make tons of money off of it. So this is the space area. This is one of those weirdos, the Hubologist. This is one of their outfits. I'm planning on getting one of the spacesuit outfits after I kill all the Hubologists. I can use the spacesuit outfits on the armor racks here. But yeah, you got the nice posters and everything up there. And yeah. So here's the western area. I need to get a western revolver to put up here. But yeah, just a couple of the outfits, some of the scenery from over there. The Gumdrop Palace. I actually managed to not kill this guy. The ghoul that lives over there. He gave me the sword and the his hat. And yeah, just a little bit of extra stuff. I plan on putting up some Nuka-Cola stuff right here too. And I need to light up the park map. But aside from that, yeah, that's pretty much it for this one. So there you go. That's a little tour of my pack rattiness. Hope y'all enjoyed that. And here you go. You can see what my getup is right now. I went for the I got the cappy glasses on just because, you know, cappy glasses. I'm using the Children of Atom armor. It's the Marine Combat armor, obviously, but just I love the designs on it. I like the circle patterns. I'm thinking about actually getting another tattoo and using some stuff from Fallout as parts of the tattoo. So we're going to hop on over to that. Get the molecular level knocked out, start working our way into the Institute. I'm fairly certain that I'm just going to wind up offing the Institute as always and staying sided with Brotherhood of Steel.
Now, indulge me for a moment by satisfying my curiosity. Tell me why you're so eager to get into the Institute.
I want to help the Brotherhood stop the Institute. It's the only way to ensure the safety of the Commonwealth.
I'm actually kind of disappointed. I wanted to tell them that it was for my wife, because usually when you choose the B option, you're kind of an asshole with whatever you say. I like being an asshole, especially to the Brotherhood of Steel, because it's military. We're supposed to be assholes. Respectful, but assholes. We're gonna go down to the airport, eh? I think I can manage that. Didn't even give me a boom. Fucking game. I need all of this cloth, clearly. Okay, so we've cleaned up the airport now. I thought I would show y'all an interesting little thing. It took me to my like third playthrough to realize this, but you can actually go up here while in workshop. What's even better? Oop. Okay, yeah, so you got like that much space. I think you might be able to get this. Hold up. Nah, but what a lot of people don't know about, lucky what's sitting right shell. Yeah. Just free mini nuke. Why the fuck not, right? Alright, but anyway, so, yeah, all that's left to do now is build the actual relay, which I think I might actually have enough stuff inside of this to do it. I don't know. Not for certain, but. I really wish Proctor Angham would run her happy ass the fuck over here. Kind of fucked up because she didn't have any legs, but whatever. She figured it out, so she figured out how to fuck together.
Here's End of the World by Skeeter Davis. Well, I think it may be a little melodramatic there, Skeets, but that's just me.
So, truth be told about this song, End of the World, this is, I hate to admit it, but even though I'm, you know, 23 years old, I'm still very much, I love old school music. Frank Sinatra, James Dean, Dean Martin, all that kind of stuff, Rat Pack, that kind of music I really do enjoy. And that particular song is just, I really do wish they made music like that nowadays, but nope, we're all going to do the Dougie. All right, Bunker Hill, where are you at? So, the Old North Church, it's the home of the railroad. Most people know that. Except this one's not really the home of the railroad anymore. Oh, what? Okay, so, like I said, I've put in nearly 600 hours on this game. I've played it through 5 times. I'm on my 6th. I've never been inside this place. This game always leaves you surprised. I don't understand why this is in there. Why this was included in the game. It didn't really seem to have much of a purpose to it. Ah, well, I could see that being useful. There's a hell of a lot of lead you can pick up in here. I need to remember that. I'm planning on building a fully functional factory, ammo factory, at one of my settlements. And those will come in handy when I start trying to build ammo. I don't know if there's anything in here of use. I mean, it's just a neat little addition. Just one more thing to kind of add some more flavor to the story, I suppose. Oh, well. Onward we go.
Let's see what you have.
Just think how damn good it'll feel holding one of these.
Oh, well, but I've always figured that she was just gonna like whip out a dong or something on that one. It'd be appropriate. I don't know why I say shit that I say.
Need some ammo there? I just machined up a couple of boxes and tried
to get it. Oh, God. So, everyone just saw that. 556. 0.556. No. Bethesda, y'all usually do a really good job at catching shit like that. What the fuck?
Hey there.
Nice.
Remarkable work, Knight. The signal interceptor appears to be complete. Are you ready to put it to the test?
Lab rat, standing by.
All of us are aware of the risk we're taking. And we
celebrate. I love how Max never reacts to any of the fucking sarcasm.
We've attempted to directly adapt Institute technology.
Unless I end up inside solid rock.
Let's hope it doesn't come to that.
It's fucking hilarious.
Once you've entered the Institute, there's a special project we're working on, and it needs her attention.
Speech check!
What's this project that needs her attention?
Dr. Lee previously worked on a potent weapon for the Brotherhood of Steel. We'd like her to continue where she left off. That's all I can tell you. Listen, Knight, I'm well aware that you're risking your life going into the Institute blind. Just keep your mind on the mission.
Pull yourself together and get up onto that platform.
Fuck you, bitch. I'm up here.
I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
I could kill you. Right here. Right now.
Yes. Yes, you could. And I would be powerless to stop you.
I want answers, asshole. Now.
Under the circumstances, I will forgive your vulnerability. But I need you to realize that this situation is far more complicated than you. And finally, Doc.
Okay, so I finished all the bullshit talking with Father. I was a complete asshole to him the entire time, of course, because that's what I'm supposed to do. I've only been recording for about an hour and a half now, so we're gonna be doing some more skip through. I'll go meet all the fucking people and everything else, and come back to you in a second. I'm popping back in right now just to kind of point out something. I'm pretty much not gonna come back here after I've done met all the people and can tell Father to fuck off. Pretty much not gonna come back here. I'd have to gather Dr. Lee, but that's. I think I should have enough evidence right now to do that. So when you go through and collect the specialized canisters for. You go through and collect all the stuff to get Virgil, his little fucking miracle serum cure shit. You can actually pick up all the evidence required to convince Dr. Lee to rejoin the Brotherhood of Steel. Needless to say, once I realized that, or at the playthrough I've done, I tried to speed up the process. Because don't get me wrong, I love playing the game, but the grinding gets very repetitive and very annoying very quickly. So.
Your work could be instrumental in freeing the Commonwealth.
You really know how to push my buttons, don't you? You know, I never understood why the Institute was so damn selfish. All those innocent people up there, dying. And here I am, surrounded by technology that could make their lives better. Yet we hide down here and insulate ourselves from... It's not right. It's not right. I'll make my way back to the Brotherhood. But I'm going to have to do it on my own. I can't take any chances being seen with you. Tell whoever sent you that they've just regained the services of Dr. Madison Lee. Now, for the
apparently you don't need any of the.
Let me see that pit boy.
Apparently you don't need any of the stuff about Virgil if you have a high enough speech check. I'm level 10 freaking charisma because yo, charisma will get you further in this fucking game than any of your other stats.
I assure.
Did want to break in to give you all a side note. The Experiment 18A, probably one of the best plasma weapons you can get a hold of in the game, except for one of the, like, the random legendaries you can pick up. I'm assuming there's more out there, like a never-ending or whatever. Anyway, this weapon you definitely want to get before you, it's the right term, part ways, I guess, with the Institute, because once you've pissed them off, you can't get it back, because the vendor sells it, and once you piss them off, you can't use the vendor anymore. Alright guys, so I completed the Institute portion. I talked to everybody I needed to. I'm going to leave their current quest in the air just so I can keep going back and getting more stuff from them. It probably won't be that difficult to get back in and out, get all the stuff that I want within the next couple of playthroughs. It's going to take some grinding, which will all, of course, be off screen, because let's face facts, nobody wants to watch. Nobody wants to watch somebody go for hours at a time, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, collecting aluminum. So I will spare y'all from that. But anyway, hope y'all enjoyed it. This has been Fallout 4 with Cardock. It's one of the few games that I won't say I'm a scrub at. I've put quite a few hours into this, and I'm not too shabby at it at this point. So Yeah, hope y'all enjoyed it. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see y'all in the next one. Bye-bye.